guys have got the belts right here, the Southern Tag Team titles. You won them in the tournament. I know you're not happy about what happened after that, though.
You know, Dave, before we start talking about what happened last week, I just, you know, Eddie and myself, we've been doing a lot of thinking. You know, when Jackie called, you know, and he asked us, you know, we had a chance to come back home and be a part of something that it's one of the biggest things in the country. You know, Jackie Fargo, you know, he's known all over the country. And it was a big thing, you know, to come back and especially to get to be one of Jackie Fargo's fabulous ones. You know, but just like I said last week, I don't know, we won the match, we won the belts, and but when we was laying there, Norvell and Coco or whatever they want to be called, I don't, you know, that right now I'm talking about something that really, it's bothered Eddie and it's bothered me all week. We was laying there, we was both bloody and you know, about half out of it, and we heard some boos, you know, some people booing out in the crowd. And I mean, you know, I've been on both sides of the fence. I mean, everybody ain't going to like you all the time, but it was more than just a few of the people booing, you know, and Eddie and myself, you know, to win them belts, it was, you know, I've won the world heavyweight title at one time. I held that, and that was a big thriller. But to come home, Memphis, Tennessee, and to win the belts, you know, it was the biggest thing that ever happened. And just like I said, we was laying there, and after we got back to the back, you know, we sat in the back for a long time, and we talked about it. And, you know, all we could come up with was that a lot of the people thought we were here trying to replace Steve Kern and Stanley Lane. Well, that's not what we're here for. That's Eddie Gilbert. I'm Tommy Rich. The name The Fabulous Ones, Jackie Fargo made that name. And as far as Stan and Steve, you know, they were very good friends of Eddie's and mine both. They're the ones that wanted to go to Minnesota, to New York, and travel all over the country. I mean, I've done it, but I wanted to come home, and I had a chance. And what I'm saying is, I don't really know what exactly I'm trying to say, but it's like when I was 11 years old, you know, I was 11 years old and my father, he went off, you know, he went off and left my mother and me, you know, and I thought, well, nobody can ever take his place. And my mother, you know, after it was over, sure, she's seen some other men, and I kind of held it against the men, you know. I'd go to sleep, and during the night, I'd get mad. I'd wake up, and at first, I'd be mad at them men. But when I was laying in that ring last week, with blood all over me, and I heard them people booing, you know, I kind of thought, you know, I realized it wasn't them men's fault that was coming to see my mother. You know, my father, he's the one that left. He's the one that wanted to leave. And I mean, it wasn't like they were trying to take his place. He's the one that chose to leave. And I don't know if that's the same thing that I mean, it's not is, I mean, that's my family's what I'm trying to say there. But all these people, you know, we come home, we're doing it for Jackie Fargo, but we're doing it for all these people out here too. That's what it's all about. Just like Jackie said, you know, they're the backbone. They're what makes wrestling happen. And all I want to say is that we're not here to take Steve and Stan's place. We're here as Eddie Gilbert and Tommy Rich, and we're going to do it just like it's supposed to be done. And we ain't going to let Jackie down and none of these dead-gone people out here.
Well said, I think. Yeah.
Tommy's right. That's exactly what I've been thinking. But you know.